A very warm good morning to one and all present over here class. Welcome to the digital platform of APS. Now this is Pavan Kumar. Today is the 18th lecture of chapter 6 application of derivative. In previous lecture class I have discussed exercise 6.5 numericals. So now today I will start chapter 6 miscellaneous of application of derivative. So let us start with a question. So see, now this is the question number 4 of miscellaneous, chapter 6 miscellaneous question number 4. Find the equation of normal to the curve y square is equal to 4x at the point 1, 2. We have to find out the equation of normal to the curve y square is equal to 4x at the point 1, 2. So the given equation of curve, see, solution, the given equation of curve, that is y square is equal to 4x. So now you know the given equation of curve, then how you will differentiate? D by dx of y square is equal to d by dx of 4x. This result will be 2y dy by dx is equal to 4. So now dy by dx is equal to 4 by 2y. This is 2 upon y. This is the value of 2 upon y. Means this is the slope of tangents. This is the slope of tangents. Slope of tangent, that is dy by dx at 1, 2. Suppose slope of tangents at 1, 2, that is dy by dx at x is equal to or 1, 2, you can write this will be equal to 2 whole upon y, value of y is 2. So result is 1. This is the slope of tangents. So what will be their normal? Normal. Therefore, slope of normal, that will be equal to, you know, their product, the slope of their product will be equal to minus 1. The slope of normal will be equal to minus 1. So when you will multiply 1 by minus 1, result you will get minus 1. So slope of normal is minus 1. And the normal is also passes through the point 1, 2. So the equation of normal passing through 1, 2 having slope minus 1. So what will be the result? Y minus 2 is equal to minus 1 x minus 1. So result will be y minus 2 is equal to minus x plus 1. This implies x plus y is equal to 3. This is the equation of normal. And you can write here x plus y minus 3 is equal to 0 is the equation of normal. This is the equation of normal. So this is the answer. And suppose we are going to draw the graph. Say here y square is equal to 4x is the standard equation of right hand parabola. So I have drawn here right hand parabola. Suppose x axis and y axis. So right hand parabola, the parabola is passes through the origin. So suppose this is the parabola. This parabola is passes through origin. And vertex coordinate is 0, 0. Focal coordinate is equating to 4a, that will be 1. So 1 comma 0 will be the foci coordinates, 1 comma 0, and you know this is the point 1 comma 2 will be the points here. 1 comma 2 will be the points here. So equation of normal will be x plus y is equal to 3. So this is the line, that is the normal. Normal, and this is the line, that is the tangent, and this is the normal, and this is the point 1, 2, and its equation is x plus y is equal to 3. So this is the figure. Now this question is completed. Now come to the next question. The next question is, now this is question number 3 of miscellaneous chapter 6. Two equal sides of an isosceles triangle with the base B. With the base B means base is given, are decreasing at the rate of 3 cm per second. Base is decreasing at the rate of 3 cm per second. Not base, not isosceles triangle. Two equal sides or equal sides of an isosceles triangle with a base B are decreasing, means two equal sides are decreasing at the rate of 3 cm per second, and this is base B. Base B is not decreasing. How fast is the area decreasing when two equal sides are equal to the base? So this is the necessary condition. So now see the solution. Let a small a be the two equal sides of an isosceles triangle. Sides of an isosceles triangle with the base B. With the base B, and B is given. Base is given. So now consider, this is an isosceles triangle. Suppose ABC is an isosceles triangle. ABC and small a are two equal sides of an isosceles triangle, and this is the length B. This is given in this question. This is given in this question. So now if you draw the perpendicular from vertex to the base will divides equally divides by this perpendicular. So this length will be equal to this length. Suppose AM is the length of perpendicular drawn from A to BC, and you also know this is the property of equilateral isosceles triangle. The line perpendicular drawn through the vertex bisect the base. So this side will be equal, and this length will be B by 2, and also this length will be equal to B by 2. So this is the figure, and how you can calculate their areas. Therefore area of isosceles triangle that is 1/2, you know, 1/2 base is B, and into height is AM. So now how you can calculate AM by using Pythagoras theorem? From figure AM will be equal to root over A square minus B square by 4. This is the value of AM. Suppose this is equation 1 and this is equation 2. Now using 2 in 1, what will be the area? एरिया ऑफ आइसोसेलेस ट्राइंगल दैट विल बी इक्वल टू बी बाय टू एम लेंथ इज ए स्क्वायर माइनस बी स्क्वायर बाय फोर दिस इज आवर एरिया सो नाउ यू कैन सपोज कैपिटल ए इज अ सिंबोलिक रिप्रेजेंटेशन ऑफ एरिया एंड वी हैव टू फाइंड आउट हाउ फास्ट इज द एरिया डिक्रीजिंग means we have to calculate dA by dt and in this question this is given d small a by dt dA by dt is equal to 3 centimeter per second decreasing means it will be negative sign so d small a by dt is given and we have to find out d capital A by dt so now you can see dA by dt from this expression dA by dt will be dA by dt calculation will be equal to d by dt of b by 2 a square minus b square by 4 and you know b is given so it will be a constant so now when you will go to differentiate what you will get the result b by 2 is constant term and its differentiation is first of all 1 by 2 into root over a square minus b square by 4 into 2a dA by dt. So this is our calculation. So now if you will calculate here, 2 will cancel out and a into b result ab with whole upon 2 times this result is 4a square minus b square whole upon 4 and it will be outside bracket square root that will be 2 into dA by dt and 2 term will cancel out so what will be the result now if you will calculate AB whole upon root over 4a square minus b square into dA by dt and according to question dA by t is 3 centimeter per second so this is 3 centimeter per second this is decreasing so it will be negative result is dA by dt so now It's a result. We have to calculate dA by dt. How fast is the area decreasing when two equal sides are equal to the base? Equal sides are equal to the base means sides are equal to the base means A is equal to B. For A is equal to B, we have to calculate the rate of change of area. So we have to calculate dA by dt. dA by dt at A is equal to B then what will be the value at A is equal to B means you have to equate A is equal to B so when A is equal to B then result will be minus A square and minus 3 square you can write minus 3 A square and B ke place pe agar A put karte hain to ye result bhi aa jayega root over 3 A square So this is the calculation. Root 3 term will cancel out. Then a result will be minus root 3 and a square cancel out. Result will be root 3a. So minus root 3a or you know a is equal to b. So minus root 3b also. You can write. So this is the rate of change of area is decreasing. Area will be decreased when the two sides of an isosceles triangle with base B are decreasing. Two sides are decreasing, then its area will be decreasing. So now, this is the answer. This is complete solution. Now, this is the question number 15 of chapter 6 miscellaneous. So, what is the question? See here. Show that the altitude means height of right circular cone of maximum volume. The question is asking about right circular cone of maximum volume and the volume of cone, that is 1 by 3 pi r square h, that can be inscribed in a sphere. Cone is inscribed in a sphere of radius r, means sphere is given whose radius r is also given. So, first of all, draw the sphere. I have drawn a sphere. Now, solution. Let given a sphere. Of radius r, radius r, and let suppose this is the sphere of radius small r, a cone of radius capital R with height means altitude, height you can write, altitude is small h. So now suppose this is the cone, of radius, that is capital R, and its height is, you can suppose this height is small h. So this is the height, overall length A B O C. OA is equal to H and OC is equal to capital R. And from figure, suppose this is the P, center of cone or center of sphere. When you will join from C, you will get also R. So R I have drawn here. This is the overall figure terminologies. So now, from figure, what can you say about R? This length will be equal to whole length minus R. AP is equal to R, means H minus R. Result will be H minus R. This is the length of OP. So R square can be written as H minus R whole square plus R square. This is the value of H and R relation. So now you can simplify here. R square is equal to H square plus R square minus 2HR plus capital R square. So, R square term will cancel out. So, what will be the result of H and R? So, 2HR minus h square will be equal to r square. So now we have, suppose here 2hr minus h square is equal to capital R square. So right here, what is the volume of cone? Since you know the volume of cone, that is V is equal to 1 by 3 pi into R square. What is the radius of cone? That is capital R. So R square into what is height? That is H. So R square value you know. Suppose this is equation 1 and this is equation 2. So from equation 1 and 2, you can write pi by 3 into R square. Result is 2HR minus R square into H. This is the value of V in terms of H. And small r is constant because R is given. You can write here R is equal to given in this question. So this will be constant. If H will multiply inside the bracket, then a result will be pi by 3 2h square r minus r square into h. So you have to calculate dv upon dt or dh. dh upon dt is not given, so you will calculate dv upon dh. So dv upon dh result will be equal to pi by 3 into d by dh of this part. Result will be 4HR minus R square. This is the value of dV by dH. And for maximum or minimum, you will equating to 0. dV upon dH, you will equate to 0. So see, since dV by dH, dV by dH you will equate to 0, this implies pi by 3 bracket 4HR minus R square will equating to 0, you will get the result 4HR minus R square is equal to 0. It means 4HR is equal to, or you can now take common R, so 4H minus R equating to 0, and you will get the value 4H is equal to R. 4H is equal to R. This is the value. Now you will see there is a mistake. This will be small h square. See everyone, there is a mistake. This will be h square, and so this will be h cube. So now this is the result. When you will differentiate, result will be 3h square, and this will be 3 times h square, and equating to 0, this result will be 3h square, and you cannot take common, so h will be common. That will be 4r minus 3h is equal to 0. So 4r minus 3h, because you know there is a mistake. Why? Because R square will be the sum of H minus R whole square plus R square. And R square term will cancel out. So what will be the result? 2RH minus small h square. So this is the small h square. So now you will equate to 0, you will get the value 4R minus 3H is equal to 0. This implies H is equal to 4R by 3, H is equal to 4R by 3. So this is the relation between H and R. Now you have to calculate second derivative. So second derivative result, what will be the D2V whole upon DH2. So result will be pi by 3 in bracket. This result will be 4R and minus, this result is 6H. So 4R minus 6H with pi by 3 is the second derivative with respect to H. And you know, you have the value H is equal to 4R by 3. And when you will put H is equal to 4R by 3, what you will get the result? D2V whole upon DS2 at H is equal to 4R by 3. D2V whole upon DS2 at H is equal to 4R by 3. Result will be pi by 3 4R minus 6 times 4R by 3. And 3 to your 6, result will be 8R. And 4R minus 8R result will be minus 4R. So pi by 3 with minus 4R and the result is negative. Negative means maximum. This shows the volume of cone is maximum when H is equal to 4R by 3. This is the altitude of right circular cone. Of maximum volume that can be inscribed in a sphere of radius R is, this is the altitude. Means you can write volume of cone is maximum when the altitude of cone is 4R by 3. This is the answer. So now completed. Now come to the next question. Now this is the question number 19 of chapter 6 miscellaneous. A cylindrical tank of radius 10 meter. Now suppose a cylindrical tank I have drawn of radius 10 meter. This is the radius and its height suppose small h. Small h is the height of cylinder. So now a cylindrical tank of radius is being filled with weight at the rate of, means cylindrical tank is filled with weight at the rate of 314 cubic meter. So volume, see the solution. Let small r and h be the radius and the height of cylindrical tank. Height of cylindrical tank. So what will be the volume? Volume of tank, that is V, is equal to pi r square h. This is the volume. According to question, this is given. dv by dt is equal to 314 cubic meter per hour. This is given. And suppose this is equation 1, differentiate equation 1 with respect to v. Then you will get dv by dt is equal to pi into d by dt of r square into h. In this question or in this figure, cylindrical tank is filled with weight. So its radius cannot be changed. Its radius cannot be changed. So radius will be fixed and height is increasing. So r square will be also a constant. So this will be pi into r square dh upon dt. And you know, dv by dt result. dv by dt, you know, dv by dt value is 314 cubic meter per hour is equal to pi times r square. Radius is given. Radius is 10 meter. So this is 10 square into dH upon dt. This is the rate of change of height. And in this question, then the depth of weight is increasing at the rate of. Means we have to calculate dH upon dt. So now dH upon dt you can write. dH upon dt result will be 314 cubic meter per hour whole upon pi into 100. 10 into 10, 100. And result is 314 upon 3.14 multiplied by 100, result will be 314. So 314 upon 314, result will be dH upon dt means meter per hour. This is the dH upon dt. So answer will be 1 meter per hour. So 1 meter per hour. This is the radius 10 meter, meter square, and a dH unit will be meter per hour. So in this question, option is given cubic meter. All answer is given in cubic meter. So this will be the answer. But cubic meter is there will be some mistakes. So first of all, A will be the first option that is correct. So now this is completed.